שוב אליי, חיונית לוי בוושינגטון, חוזרים לראיון המיוחד שהקלטת לפנות בוקר עם הנשיא אובמה. אחרי שנה וחצי בתפקיד, איזה נשיא פגשת?
דני, אם יש משפט אחד אולי שאפשר בעזרתו לסכם את הרעיון הזה, הרעיון מאוד נרחב ומאוד ככה בטון סימפטי שמעניק הנשיא ברק אובמה לחדשות ערוץ 2, המשפט שחוזר ככה שוב ושוב במהלך הרעיון הזה הוא: אני מבין אתכם, אבל אני מבין את החששות של הישראלים, אבל חלון ההזדמנויות לשלום הולך ואוזל. אני מבין שאתם חוששים ממני כי אני גם פונה לעולם המוסלמי, אבל אני בעדכם. וכן, אני גם מבין שתלו בי ציפיות גדולות וגבוהות מאוד כשנבחרתי, אבל כפוליטיקאי בבית הלבן אתה תמיד מאכזב מישהו. אז הנה בפניכם הרעיון המיוחד לחדשות ערוץ 2, נשיא ארצות הברית ברק אובמה.
President Barack Obama, shalom, and thank you so much
you.
for talking with us today.
Thank you very much.
I'd like to actually open up by asking you about hope,
yeah.
which was such a prominent notion in your
right.
campaign and in your presidency.
Right.
And how can you convey that concept of hope to Israelis who've seen, you know, so many failed attempts
right.
at a peace process?
Well, look, it's always a challenge. One of the things I used to say during the campaign, but also at the beginning of my presidency, is being hopeful is not the same as being blindly optimistic. I think you have to be clear-eyed about the situation. And Israelis rightly look at the past and you know, have skepticism about what's possible. They see the enmity of neighbors that surround them in a very tough neighborhood. They see a track record of attempts at peace where even when concessions were made, a deal could not be consummated. They see rockets fired from Gaza or from areas in Lebanon. And say to themselves that you know, the hatreds or history are so deep-seated that change is not possible. And yet, if you think back to the founding of Israel, there were a lot of people who you know, thought that that wasn't possible either. And you know, if you know, Herzl or Ben-Gurion were looking at Israel today, they would be astonished at what they saw. A country that's vibrant, that is growing economically at an extraordinary pace, that has overcome not just security challenges, but also has been able to overcome challenges related to geography. And so that should be a great source of hope.
Is a peace agreement, in your opinion, can be reached in the first term of your presidency?
I think so. I had an excellent meeting with Prime Minister Netanyahu, and I think that he is somebody who understands that we've got a fairly narrow window of opportunity. On the Palestinian side, moderates like Abu Mazen and Fayyad are, I think, willing to make the concessions and engage in negotiations that can result in peace. But their time frame in power may be limited if they aren't able to deliver for their people. You know, there's a constant contest between moderates and rejectionists within the Arab world. And then there's the demographic challenges that Israel's going to be facing if it wants to remain not only a Jewish state, but a democratic state. So you look at all these pressures and you say to yourself, we probably won't have a better opportunity than we have right now. And that has to be seized. Now, it's going to be wrenching. It's going to be difficult.
Do you believe that Benjamin Netanyahu is the right man? You believe that he can bring peace?
Yeah, I think that not only is Prime Minister Netanyahu a smart and savvy politician. But the fact that he is not perceived as a dove in some ways can be helpful, in the sense that, you know, any successful peace will have to include the hawks and the doves on both sides. And in the same way that Richard Nixon here in the United States was able to go to China because he had very strong anti-communist credentials, I think Prime Minister Netanyahu may be very well positioned to bring this about. And in our conversations yesterday, I had the impression that Prime Minister Netanyahu isn't interested in just occupying a space, a position, but he's interested in being a statesman and putting his country on a more secure track. So I hope that opportunity is seized. But ultimately, one of the things you learn very quickly, whether you're president or a prime minister, is that your power derives from the people. And it goes back to your first question. The Israeli people are going to have to overcome legitimate skepticism, more than legitimate fears, in order to get a change that I think will secure Israel for another 60 years.
You know, you met with him on Tuesday, and you both said that the meeting was excellent. And, you know, perfect photo and idyllic photo notwithstanding, it hasn't exactly been smooth sailing in your relationship so far.
Well, you know, some of this has been greatly overstated. I mean, the last time that the Prime Minister came here, we had a terrific meeting.